herpes is a viral illness or disease, and we found there's mostly two types, herpes simplex virus 1 and 2. We originally thought that the herpes simplex virus 1 would only be infections such as fever, blisters, or cold sores above the belt, whereas herpes type 2, we felt, would only be herpes that would be affected in the genital area. We found since that herpes 1 or 2 can be found either place. When you've had infection by the herpes virus, it changes your antibodies to where you've had the infection and it can lie dormant, and people can get reinfected when they have times of stress. When you have an active blister, particularly in the genital area, it's wise not to have sex at that time. And if you did, use protection such as condoms, because it can transmit from the mucous membranes from one person to another. So kissing with an active herpes lesion on your mouth could transmit that same fever blister to another person. So it's important to just, when you're having an infection, to avoid doing that. There are medications that can clear up that infection at that time. And some people have multiple infections or outbreaks several times a month, and you can also nowadays take medication that you take routinely every day to help prevent recurrences from occurring. If a woman were to contract a herpes infection in her vaginal area, it's important in pregnancy at the time of delivery, she would need to be delivered by C-section because the herpes virus can be transmitted to the newborn. And there are medications that can be given in the last 6 weeks or so of pregnancy to try to reduce a person from having an outbreak in the pregnancy. If anyone has any concerns or questions regarding fever blisters or different sores on their body, that it's a good time to see your doctor and talk about that and perhaps have some testing. You can do a culture of the virus, and now we have some blood testing available as well.